Hi, I'm Brendan Flutis, and today we're going to be talking about the AP odontoid cervical spine. So the AP odontoid cervical spine is used to see the dens, also called the odontoid process, between C1 and C2. Okay, so for an AP cervical spine open mount, we have the tube at 40 SID from the wall bucky. We also have a 10x12 portrait in the wall bucky. And we have the wall bucky at an appropriate height for somebody that we would do this exam on. Okay, so now we're going to go get our patient from the waiting room. Ms. Flutis? Hi, Ms. Flutis. I'm Brian. So we're going to take a few x-rays of your neck, if you can follow me this way. So how did you injure your neck, Ms. Flutis?
I fell down the stairs.
So we have our room set up and our patient is ready. We just need to make sure that the tube is at the correct height. We need to make sure that it's between her lips. If you can go ahead and open your mouth. Because we want to make sure we get the dens in this image. And it looks like it's at right in between her lips and it's at a correct height. And the tube is at 40 SID. So we need to make sure that the base of her skull is lined up with the lower margin of her upper incisors. So the central ray should be at the mid-sagittal plane, and it should be in the middle of her mouth. Looks like we're ready to take our first image.
Shield!
Okay, so before we take this image, we're going to ask the patient to hold their breath. And the anatomy that should be demonstrated is the odontoid process, body of C2, lateral masses and transverse process of C1, and the zygapophyseal joints, which should be demonstrated in this open mouth projection.
And I'm going to be demonstrating the AP axial projection of the cervical spine. So I have my tube angled at a 20 degree cephalid angle, and it's at 40 SID. I'm centered to my bucky, and I'm using a 10x12 cassette portrait. Now I'll go get my patient. Jillian Copley.
Hi, I'm Renee. I'm the technologist. I'll be taking your x-rays of your neck area. Can you verify your date of birth for me?
4/16/89.
Okay, thank you. And do you have a wristband?
Okay, so can you tell me how this happened to you?
Yeah, I got whiplash because some idiot ran in front of my car in the parking lot.
Oh, really?
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Okay, everything's good. Now we're going to get you started. Okay, so our central ray is at C4, which is about the middle of your neck. And mid-sagittal plane. You're going to collimate to only the area of interest, which is just the spine, so you don't want to get too much of the mouth or too much of the chest. And then make sure you mark your right side. I'm going to mark her right side. And you're going to suspend respiration.
Shield!
So the anatomy demonstrated for this projection is going to be the C3 to T2 vertebral bodies, the space between the pedicles, and your intervertebral disc spaces seen clearly.
Hello, my name is Brooke. I'm going to be the tech demonstrating the oblique projections on the cervical spine. First, we have a 10 by 12 cassette in the upright bucky set at an appropriate height for somebody who's going to be having this exam. We have our tube in a horizontal beam, and we have our SID set at 72. Alrighty, so now let's go get our patient. Ready? Mr. Flores? Hi, my name is Brooke. I'm going to be the tech performing your x-rays today. First, I have to ask you a couple questions. Did they give you a wristband?
Mm-hmm.
May I go ahead and take a look at it? Alrighty, perfect. Now, what's your birthday, sir?
9/15/1765.
Alrighty, looks good. If you'll follow me back to the room. So, Mr. Flores, how did this injury take place?
Some crazy blonde lady wearing blue scrubs who actually works here hit me with her car.
Alright, so for our first projection, we're going to be starting with an anterior oblique. We have our tube at a 72 SID with a 20 degree caudate angle. We have the central ray at C4. This is an anterior oblique, so this is an RAO. We have his right side touching the wall bucky. We have the bucky and the tube aligned. We have our right marker. You just can't see it. His shoulder is blocking it. And we have the patient at a 45 degree angle with his neck and head facing laterally. For our next projection, we're going to be doing posterior obliques. So we have the tube at a 72 SID with a 20 degree cephalid angle. We have our patient aligned with the bucky. The central ray is at C4. We have him turned at a 45 degree angle, and his right side is touching the wall bucky, and we have his neck and his head at a true lateral position.
Shield!
For the anterior obliques, the anatomy demonstrated are the intervertebral foramina and the pedicels on the side of the patient closest to the IR. For the posterior obliques, the anatomy demonstrated is the intervertebral foramina and pedicels on the side of the patient furthest from the IR.
Demonstrating the lateral C-spine position. For this position, my tube is at 72 inches and it's horizontally aligned to the bucky. I also have a 10 by 12 IR placed in here
portrait.
Now let's go get our patient. Miss Gatewood?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Jillian.
Hi.
I'm going to take a picture of your C-spine today.
Okay.
First, can you tell me your birthday?
December 19th, 2027.
Okay, and can I see your wristband?
Sure.
Okay, and can you tell me what happened?
I slipped and fell, and I hurt my neck.
Okay. So now I have my patient in position. She's in a left lateral position all the way against the board. My CR is at C4, which is about the mid-neck area. For this position, I would have her depress her shoulder slightly. And we will also expose on full expiration to get maximum depression of the shoulders.
Shield!
So the anatomy demonstrated on this projection would be the cervical vertebral bodies, the intervertebral joint spaces, the articular pillars, spinous processes, and the zygapophyseal joints.
Important notes to remember when doing an AP open mouth cervical spine is to open the mouth, only the lower jaw, have the tongue in the lower jaw to prevent superimposition over C1 and C2. If the teeth are over the dens, hyperextend or use a cephalic angle. Or if the base of the skull is over the dens, hyperflex or use a convex angle.
So some tips to remember for the AP axial C-spine is the angling demonstrates the intervertebral disc space. If the patient is supine, use a 15-degree angle. If you have the patient erect, use a 20-degree angle. And another good thing to remember, if they have a kyphotic curvature, angle it more than 20 degrees.
An additional note for the oblique projection of the C-spine, you can turn the head in a near lateral position, and this will help prevent superimposition of the mandible on the upper vertebra. Don't forget, for any trauma patient, it is critical not to remove a C-collar unless a physician has authorized to do so.
Okay, Sarah, I'm gonna take this off so you can breathe, okay? Oh no!
Mr. Jackson, I gotta go. What did I just tell you?
I'm sorry, I'm a student. For the lateral C-spine, the 72-inch SID compensates for a greater OID and it gives better spatial resolution. And then another note, if the patient is able, a 5 to 10 pound weight can help pull down their shoulders.
This image shows a clay shoveler's fracture. This fracture, which results from hyperflexion of the neck, results in avulsion fractures on the spinous processes of C6 through T1. This fracture is best demonstrated of the lateral C-spine projection. This image is a hangman's fracture. This fracture extends through the pedicles of C2 with or without subluxation of C2 or C3. This cervical fracture occurs when the neck is subjected to extreme hyperextension. A lateral projection of the cervical spine will best demonstrate the anterior displacement of C2 characteristics of a hangman fracture. This image shows a Jefferson fracture. This is a comminuted fracture, which means splintered or crushed at the site of impact. This occurs as a result of axial loading, such as that produced by landing on one's head or abruptly on one's feet. The anterior and posterior arches of C1 are fractured as the skull slams onto the ring. This fracture can be shown in a lateral C-spine as well as the AP open mouth, as shown.
Thanks for watching our video about the C-spine. Now that we've taught you a little bit about it, it's time to get to work.
Go.
I've been down every road, every city, seen every view. Chasing the stars in the back of my car, cause I hit a few. Cross every sea, you know I would. Why wouldn't I? It's just so good. Every road, every river I travel leads back to you.
Body shit!
Cross every sea, you know I would. Why wouldn't I? It's just so good.
Okay, ready?
I've been all over the world, but I'm finally here.
Shield!
Out!
Oh, Oh, darling, say something. Oh, darling, feels like this cross every single time. Why wouldn't I just so good? Oh, darling, say something. Oh, darling.